Welcome back to the channel, everyone. Today, we're diving deep into the world of software testing, specifically white box testing techniques. If you're serious about building robust and reliable applications, you're in the right place. White box testing is like having X-ray vision into your code, allowing you to see what's going on under the hood. Please keep in mind that besides the examination of code, white box testing techniques could also prove configuration files, menu definition files, data mask definition files, transaction protocols, etc. We'll explore four essential methods to give you the confidence to ship code you're proud of. So, whether you're a seasoned developer or just starting out, buckle up because we're about to unlock the secrets of white box testing.
All right, let's talk about why white box testing is so crucial in software development. It's not just a step in the process, it's a fundamental practice that ensures the quality and reliability of the software we create. Imagine building a house without inspecting the foundation, the framing, the plumbing. You get the idea. Every component needs to be checked to ensure the house stands strong and functions well. That's essentially what it's like to ship software without white box testing. You might end up with a product that looks good on the surface but is riddled with issues underneath. You might have a beautiful interface, but if the underlying code is buggy, the whole thing could come crashing down. It's like having a beautifully painted house with a cracked foundation. With white box testing, we're not just checking if the software works, we're looking at how it works. We're diving deep into the code to understand its structure and logic. We're examining the internal logic, the data flow, every single line of code to ensure it's functioning exactly as intended. This thorough examination helps us identify potential issues before they become real problems. This level of scrutiny helps us catch those sneaky bugs that might slip through other testing methods. It's about being proactive rather than reactive. It's about building software that's not just functional but also reliable and maintainable in the long run. We want to create software that stands the test of time and adapts to future needs. Think of it like this. Black box testing is like testing a car by driving it, while white box testing is like popping the hood and inspecting the engine, transmission, everything. Both are necessary, but they serve different purposes. Both are important, but white box testing gives you a much deeper understanding of what's going on and helps you prevent major issues down the line. It allows you to see the inner workings and ensure everything is running smoothly. So, whether you're building a mobile app, a web application, or even a complex enterprise system, white box testing is an absolute must. It ensures that your software is robust and can handle the demands placed upon it. It's about building software that's not just functional, but also reliable and maintainable in the long run. This approach helps in reducing technical debt and makes future updates and maintenance easier. In the upcoming chapters, we'll dive into specific white box testing techniques that will empower you to write cleaner, more robust code. Stick around. We'll explore tools, methodologies, and best practices that will elevate your testing game. First up, we have statement coverage, one of the fundamental techniques in white box testing. The goal here is simple: execute every single statement in your code at least once during testing. Think of it like a checklist. You want to make sure you've covered all the bases. Now, you might be thinking, isn't that a lot of work? And yeah, it can be, especially for larger code bases, but the payoff is huge. By ensuring every statement is executed, you're essentially shining a light on every corner of your code, exposing potential issues that might otherwise hide in the shadows. Imagine a scenario where you have a conditional statement, an if statement, that's rarely met. Without statement coverage, that block of code might go untested, potentially harboring a critical bug. Statement coverage helps you avoid these scenarios. It forces you to write test cases that exercise every part of your code, giving you the confidence that your software is as robust as can be. There are tools available that can help you measure statement coverage, giving you a clear picture of how much of your code is actually being tested. It's like having a progress bar for your testing efforts, showing you where you've been and where you still need to go. So, remember, statement coverage is all about thoroughness. It's about making sure every line of code gets the attention it deserves. But let's dive a bit deeper. Statement coverage isn't just about running through your code willy-nilly, it's a strategic approach. When you write your test cases, you need to think about all the possible paths your code can take. This means considering different inputs, edge cases, and even the unexpected. By doing so, you ensure that your code is resilient and can handle whatever comes its way. Moreover, statement coverage can also help in identifying dead code parts of your code that are never executed, This can be a sign of redundant or outdated logic that needs to be cleaned up. By removing such code, you not only make your code base cleaner but also more efficient. In essence, statement coverage is like a magnifying glass for your code. It helps you scrutinize every detail, ensuring that nothing is overlooked. So the next time you're working on a project, remember to leave no line unturned. Your future self and your users will thank you. Next up, we have branch coverage, also known as decision coverage. This is a crucial concept in software testing that ensures every possible path through a decision point is tested. This technique takes things a step further than statement coverage. While statement coverage checks if each line of code is executed, branch coverage dives deeper. Instead of just executing every statement, we're now focusing on every possible branch or decision point in our code. This means examining all the forks in the road that our code might take. Think if statements, switch statements, loops, anything that creates multiple paths of execution. Each of these constructs can lead to different outcomes based on the conditions provided. With branch coverage, we want to make sure that we've tested every possible outcome of these decision points. This means not just the obvious paths, but also the less likely ones. Did we go down the true path? This is one of the critical questions we need to answer. Did we go down the false path? Ensuring both paths are tested helps us catch potential issues early. By testing all branches, we're essentially simulating a wider range of scenarios that our software might encounter in the real world. This makes our software more robust and reliable. Imagine you're building an e-commerce app and you have a piece of code that checks if an item is in stock before adding it to the cart. This is a perfect example of where branch coverage is essential. Branch coverage would ensure that you've tested both scenarios, when the item is in stock and when it's not. This way, you can be sure that your app behaves correctly in both situations. This way, you can be confident that your app handles both cases gracefully. It's about providing a seamless user experience regardless of the situation. Branch coverage is particularly important for code bases with complex logic and multiple decision points. The more complex the code, the more critical it is to ensure every path is tested. It helps you uncover hidden bugs that might only surface under specific conditions. These are the bugs that can be the most challenging to find and fix. So if you want to take your testing game to the next level, branch coverage is a must-have in your toolkit. It's an advanced technique that pays off in the long run. It's about being thorough and ensuring that your code can handle whatever comes its way. By implementing branch coverage, you're setting your software up for success. Now let's talk about path coverage, the most comprehensive but also the most challenging white box testing technique. With path coverage, we're not just testing individual statements or branches, we're testing all possible paths through the code. Think of your code as a map with multiple roads leading to different destinations. Path coverage is about exploring every single road, every possible route, to ensure that no path leads to a dead end, or, in our case, a bug. This means testing all possible combinations of branches, loops, and conditional statements. As you can imagine, this can quickly become very complex, especially for larger code bases. The number of possible paths can explode exponentially, making it practically impossible to test every single one. However, that doesn't mean path coverage isn't valuable. Even if you can't test every single path, aiming for high path coverage can significantly improve the quality of your testing. It forces you to think deeply about the different ways your code can be executed and helps you identify critical paths that might have otherwise been overlooked. Path coverage is like the ultimate stress test for your code. It's about pushing it to its limits and ensuring that it can handle even the most unexpected scenarios. Finally, let's talk about data flow testing, a technique that focuses on how data moves through your code. With data flow testing, we're not just concerned with the code itself, but also with the data that's being manipulated by the code. Think of it like being a detective following a trail of clues. We want to see where data originates, how it's modified, and where it's ultimately used. We're looking for things like variables being used before they're initialized, variables being declared but never used, or variables being modified in unexpected ways. These types of errors can be particularly insidious because they might not always result in an immediate crash, but they can lead to subtle bugs that are hard to track down. Data flow testing helps you identify these issues early on by forcing you to think critically about how you're handling data in your code. It's about ensuring that data flows smoothly and predictably through your application, reducing the likelihood of unexpected behavior. So if you want to write cleaner, more reliable code, data flow testing is an essential technique to add to your arsenal. It's about thinking beyond the code itself and considering the entire life cycle of your data. And there you have it, four powerful white box testing techniques to help you level up your software. Remember, building robust software is like building a house. It's not just about the exterior, it's about the foundation, the framework, everything underneath. Thanks for watching. If you found this video helpful, don't forget to like, share, and subscribe for more tech insights. Leave a comment below if you have any questions or topics you'd like us to cover next. I'm always looking for new challenges and new ways to explore the world of tech. Until next time.